The following is a fan-based parody. Avatar The Last Airbender and The Legend of Korra are all owned by Viacom, Nickelodeon, Bryan Konietzko, and Michael Dante Dimartino. Please support the official release.
So guys, why did we return to the scene of Katara's crime? Do you think Mom's necklace ended up here?
Shut up, Sokka. This is a different ashy wasteland. Right, Aang?
Yeah, I guess.
Hey, Aang. Not that I'm against brooding, but you seem awfully melancholy today. Is it because this forest was burned down and you feel guilty since it's your job as the Avatar to protect the spiritual and material worlds?
We're just such a long way from Blockbuster. I feel like at this rate, we'll never get there.
And you feel bad about not protecting nature, right?
Aang, this place is boring. I want to leave.
You're the Avatar, right? I'm an old man and walking is hard, so if you're not, I'll feel really stupid. Our village is under attack by a spirit monster because we helped a crazy man burn down this forest to raise the cost of paper. Can you help?
I don't know. Sounds kind of preachy.
I agree. What payment can you promise us? Gold? Supplies? A promise to follow my Twitter profile?
I have some dice. I guess we can play a round of D&D or something.
You had us at hello.
I didn't say hello.
You have us.
There's no love like your love, and no other could give more love.
Hey, Uncle, can we talk?
Zuko, what have I said about disrupting naked Iroh time?
But this is important. You know about spirits, right? I heard there was one in the area and figured maybe we could bring it on board.
I'm gonna stop you right there. You do remember what I've said about spirits, right? Like how they're the worst and how we should never do anything with them because they're the worst?
I mean, I do recall having that talk, yes.
Then quit ruining my buzz. I'm trying to enjoy my favorite N-words in peace. Those words being nudity, nature, and not my nephew, in that order.
Gee, Uncle, you're really burning me on this. I mean, it's not as bad as that forest you burned down last week, or when my dad burned me, but it's comparable. You know, times like this, I really wonder if you actually do care about me, or my business.
And I'm starting to wonder if you'll ever stop vying for my approval like a feckless limp dick worm. Now how about you make like a limp dick and beat it? And I don't mean in the fun, but also creepy Michael Jackson way.
Well, maybe I will. And maybe you shouldn't count on me coming back for you.
Sounds good to me. Not like I ever needed you.
Fine.
Fine.
Fine. Fine.
Oh, and when you cave and come crawling back, be sure you don't skimp on the whimpering.
Yeah, the evil spirit monster Hey-Bye comes every night, breaks our stuff, and makes off of our loved ones. I admit that maybe we shouldn't have burned down that forest, but I stand with my decision. It was an eyesore.
I think I understand, but why me?
I don't know. Sounded like a good idea at the time. You're the Avatar, bridge between the spirit and mortal planes. The winter solstice is coming up, and the barrier between the worlds are blurring. Do I need to go on, or does this sound really stupid?
Incredibly stupid. Please stop talking.
Don't worry, sir. We got this. And by we, I mean Aang. Right, buddy?
I mean, I guess?
Good! Because it's happening now!
What?
Good luck!
Hey, bye. You around here? Shit, what does he even look like?
Like a mix between the Cloverfield monster and a panda bear!
A panda and a clover what? Oh! 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 Hey, you, how you doing? Hey guys, can we talk about this? I don't want to fight the monster anymore.
You got this, Aang. We believe in you.
I don't know. Aang is way out of that thing's weight class.
I believe in you.
Dang it, it's breaking our stuff again.
Oh man, damn it! Oh, I never really cared much about that. Oh, come on!
To be fair, if you're mad about deforestation, you're really hurting your case.
Eat!
Oh, I wonder if a fall from this height would be enough to kill me. No, it didn't.
Sure hope that kid has health insurance. He must have some high premiums.
He's gonna die.
Jesus Christ, what have I done? I gotta save my best friend!
Since when does Sokka have a best friend? Who is it? Do I know them?
Hey, hey, Vi! Keep your spectral mitts off my ethnically dubious bestie!
Sokka, get out of here!
I can't do that, Aang. Your friendship means too much to me. Save me, Aang! Save me!
Hey, give me back my idiot!
You guys are coming back, right?
God damn it, fine. You win, Uncle Iroh. I'm caving in just like you said, because I do need you. You know, giving me the silent treatment is real rich coming from you. Hey, Todd, I think something's wrong.
Maybe he just left.
Without rubbing in his victory? You don't know him like I do. He's in trouble. From the look of these rocks, anything could have happened. Maybe it's the ghost of that dragon he said he killed. Or it's Luten seeking vengeance from beyond the grave because he was such a terrible father. Oh my God, Cousin Luten, let Uncle Iroh go. You lived your life now, let him live his.
Or maybe he was taken by earthbenders.
Or that. Gosh, Uncle's all alone. He must be so scared.
So, what do you folks like to do for fun around here? I'd be down for some strip poker, but I'm already very naked. Does anybody else feel a draft, or is that just me?
Hey, Aang, it might just be me, but you look really weird right now.
Shut up, Sokka. I'm trying to save your ass.
Anyway, if I don't make it, I just want you to know that you're my best friend.
Well, that's good to know, I suppose. I'm not quite sure I feel the same way, but I'm very flattered.
What?
It's not that I don't like you. I just sometimes feel like you project your feelings onto me, and it's kind of dehumanizing. Like, there's more to friendship than what you think there is, and he's gone. Fuck. No. Oh, God.
So, Jerry, would you be down for a round of D&D with just one player? No? That's all right. I wouldn't play with me either.
Here, have a shitty blanket.
Thanks.
What up, Katara? Sokka's gone and I have no idea what to do. I dropped my staff, but it's all cool. Oh, that's a lie, it's not.
I just can't believe they're dead.
What?
I mean, for Aang it was bound to happen, but I would have figured maybe in his 60s from kidney failure.
Stop fantasizing about my death!
Sometimes I feel like I could still hear his voice. Which, now that I think about it, besides being annoying, is weirdly mature for a 12-year-old boy.
Katara, I'm talking to you! I'm talking to you right now! I know you can hear me, I'm blue! Oh. I'm in the spirit world! No, that doesn't make any sense! Aren't there, like, portals or something? I'm dead! I'm a ghost!
Yeah, that's him! I don't know why I know that, but whatever. I'm keeping it. It may be a long time from now, but me keeping Uncle Sweaty Sandal will somehow pay off. Full speed ahead, Bryke! By the way, I love that I named you Bryke.
Hey, Katara, now that I apparently am dead, I'm gonna haunt you. I'm gonna say mean things behind your back, and nothing you say will ever hurt me again.
Shut up, Aang. Monkey Atsu never loved you because you ran out on him.
Exactly. Wait, how did I get my staff back? Is it also a ghost?
I'm up! And you're still here? You didn't leave like... Fine. I guess you can hang around for the time being as my emotional support animal. But this doesn't change the fact that one day, I will eat you. I love you too.
I can't believe this. She's acting like her favorite show just had a terrible final season. No, I can't let this beat me. I'm not dead. I'm too important to die. Like Steve Irwin. Or Robin Williams.
or the great Stan Lee?
Too soon.
Aang?
Sokka?
Why are you such a bad friend, Aang?
Ghost dragons? When did this become an episode of Danny Phantom? And yes, Katara, I understood that reference. Ah! Okay, so I'm not dead, you're Avatar Roku's animal guide, and you want to bring me to him. Well, if we're gonna leave, there's still one last thing I need to say to my roommate. Hey, Katara! Katara! Hey, Katara! Fuck you!
I guess they're really gone. Just like my mom. And hopefully Grand.
Ah, it's the ghost of that dragon I totally killed! Really? No reaction at all to how awesome I am? Christ, this is duller than my son's wake. Bored, I'm bored! You people are boring me!
Could you please quit that?
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you not like it when I jingle my cuffs?
No, I find it particularly distracting and... Ah, come on!
Sorry, buddy. My naked body, my naked rules. Clangity-clangity-clang, bitch!
Tim, tied in the prisoner's restraints.
Ah, it burns! Why did I not expect this?
Transformers, roll out! Yeet! Gentlemen, Tim, you will always remember this day as the day you almost caught the great dragon of the... West.
Okay, Appa. Now that it's just us, I guess we'll have to find new people to join up with. How about Zuko? He seems gullible.
Yes, we have no bananas.
Hey, Zuko, huh? Wanna join my team?
Sorry, Katara, but I'm kinda busy with something at the moment.
Okay, I totally understand.
Also, you wouldn't happen to be missing a necklace with vague ties to your traumatic backstory, would you? I found one a while back, and I figured-
Sorry, not listening anymore. You're not very important to me. Bye!
I like our talks. Come on, Brike! We have no bananas today!
Alright, so you brought me to Roku's temple in the Fire Nation so I could look at a statue. Oh god, is this about me not measuring up to him? Because I already got an earful of that back at the Kyoshi village and- Oh god, not again! Okay, so there's a comet coming and... What? No, that can't be! This isn't funny! Stop! Stop showing me this! Why are you doing this to me? So it's a light that moves each day until it hits the statue on the solstice. I get it. So I need to be here in person so I can talk to Roku- Oh god damn it! I fucking hate you. I'm alive and I have my staff and I hate spirit so much. But it looks like I'm not yet done with them.
Alright, so you're alive, and now we have to go to the Fire Nation?
Yeah, but first I need to do something. I reckon it's time we bring back our idiot.
Sounds good to me. So, Aang, you didn't happen to hang around me when I thought you and Sokka were dead, right?
Oh, well, actually... No, I didn't see any of that stuff. I left right away.
Oh, good. Because even if you did, I was totally prepared to lose you guys.
Yeah. Yeah, I believe you. Any chance we can just call this a day, fellas? I'm naked and slabbed over a rock. It's like my ex-wife all over again.
Shut up, jerk! You're a bad person!
Wow. What a cunning, cutting, and well-thought-out put-down, Tim. When all this is over, I think I'm gonna miss you the most.
What do you mean by that?
Look, guys, we're just gonna have to smash his hands and go from there. You know? So he can't murder us!
Aw, you're saying it like it's a bad thing.
Yeet! Yeet!
Alright, Zuko, you might be overdoing it with those yeets.
Yeah, I kind of figured. So is this an admission that you really do need me?
It's as much an admission that someone's gonna need to get me a beer when I'm done flushing these turds.
Now take it!
Aw, man, now I can't feel my other hand! And I don't have insurance!
For the record, while I could have taken care of that myself, thanks for the help. I suppose I should keep you around, limp dick and all.
Well, for the record, I need you too.
You know it's true.
Everything I do, I do it for you. So, Zuko, did you ever find my sandal?
No. Why ask?
This is not better! This is just as bad as before!
Do a barrel roll!
Like a mix between the Cloverfield monster and a Panda-Bear! Panda-Bear! Panda-Bear!
Hey, Jerry, are you repeating what you said earlier for dramatic effect?
No.
Okay, just wondering.
I have had enough with you! Look, pal, I get you're angry. Some days we all just want to throw shit in the air and kidnap folks. But you're not the only one who's hurting. I just learned today that I'll never get to meet the great Stan Lee. So get in line! Stop attacking these people! Give me back my idiot best friend and take this stupid acorn!
Excelsior!
Panda-Bear! Panda-Bear! Panda-Bear!
You do you, Jerry.
Okay, I've decided! Spirits are the worst! Let's never do anything with them ever again! I don't care if I sound racist!
Sokka!
Sis? Why are you hugging me?
This is just another of Heibai's illusions! You're still in the spirit world!
That's a lie. She missed you.
Aww. No, I didn't. I didn't miss you. I was glad you were dead. You too, Aang, you 112-year-old creep. Damn it, I hate being vulnerable.
When I sent out old Jerry to find the Avatar, I figured he was gonna die of dysentery. This is way better.
We get that a lot. So in exchange for services rendered, can we have stuff?
Sure thing! And after that, we'll get back to cutting down trees to rebuild our village, because we didn't learn anything! Hell yeah!
Bitchin'. Alright, so next stop is some Fire Nation Island?
Yep, so I can commune with a dead guy and figure out what the hell is going on. Should be pretty lit.
You know, I'm in a good enough mood that I'm gonna let you have that one.
That sounds great and all, but Aang, when I was in the spirit world, I thought long and hard about what you said to me. And there's something I need to say to you.
Okay. What is it, Sokka?
Fuck you.